Good evening, everybody. Do you still remember the last time lesson? Is it the prepositions of place? So today we will continue the same topic, prepositions of time. So how do we use preposition on, in, at, or for to express the time? So the first preposition in. When do we use preposition in? We use in before years, months, seasons, or part of today. For more illustrations, so let's have a look at the example. The first one, I met him in July. July is the month. The next example is, I have classes in the afternoon, in the evening, in the morning. This is a period of the day, so we have to put preposition in before that. The third example, in 1975, Vietnam War ended. 1975 is in the year. Final example, I often go on vacation in the summer, in the spring, winter, or the fall. They are seasons of the year, so we put preposition in. So the second preposition is on. When do we use on? We use on before a day or the date. For example, on Sunday, we usually eat out. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, is it the day during the week? So the second example, on the 1st of May 2009, I got married. Why don't we use preposition in here before the month and the year? Because there is a appearance of the day, the first. So whenever there is appearance of the day like the first, the second, or the third, we always use preposition on. Although we have a month or the year. The third preposition is at. We usually use at before a time like 5 p.m., 7 p.m. Or some of the common expressions like at night, at day, at midday, or at the weekend. And especially before some of the festivals period like Christmas or Easter. Example, I'm going to see my friends at 9 p.m. at the weekend. Or we first met at Christmas or at Easter. So the final preposition is for. We use for before a length of time. For instance, I have lived in the city for 10 years or I have been learning English for 25 years. So I hope today's lesson will help you how to use on, in, at, or for correctly before a time expression. Thank you for watching.